We lost two soldiers, then it all changed. Nah, literally, then it was all bling. We married mainstream, thought that it was all a fling. Then the white boy came and it was all the same. Suddenly, rap was backpacking in the cul-de-sacs with skull caps and sullen facts. A gangsta rap tap, middle America, but little Erica. The parents gassed, Lindsay dropped it low, but really it was all a parent trap. Music hit the scene, ATL lit the fluid, a new black movement. From Young Jocks to Jeezy, Young Jocks to Weezy.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get free apathy. I don't really care whether you get it or not. What's going on, YouTube? It's Knox Hill, and we're back to our reaction series. So today, man, it is Thursday, aka Mathers Day, which means we have none other than Eminem back on the channel. Now, you guys know I read the comments, the good, the bad, the ugly, the troll, and this is definitely one of the next highest requested ones. I think it is perfect for this time of the year. It's time to bring back M, to bring back Yellow Wolf, Royce da 5'9", King Crooked Man. I'm talking about Psychopath Killer. But before we go any further, I gotta give a quick shout out to the song in the intro. If you guys like that, yes, I'm a rapper myself. There's a good chance you like my breakdowns, the way that I think about music. You'll probably like my music as well. I have an album, Chaos Theory, 20 tracks of blood, sweat, and tears, heart, and soul. If you want to support me and support this channel directly, I'll put that link below. But anyways, you know what we're here for. Eminem, step back up to the plate. Let's see what you got. One.
I guess you can consider a poet. Well, with me, it started out with these words. They started looking like puzzle pieces. I start connecting them to each other. Until they started to resemble blank canvases. By this time, I was an artist. So I just started to paint these pictures. Real
visual. Alright, let's talk about how it opens up. Typical horror movie type of vibe when you hear the thunderstorm crackle in the background, the rain pouring down, and then you have Royce talking in this demonic voice. But what's interesting is that it's not all twisted and dark to start with. He's actually given something profound here in the way that his mind works and his creativity. And I said this so many times about Royce and M and some of the greats. Like, they see the rhymes. They don't just write them. Like, they visualize, and it's like, it's color-coded, the way that their rhyme patterns, they just lock into sounds and vowels, and the way that they make them line up and bend words and schemes, it's on another level. It is something just that goes beyond just simple sensory of writing. It's visualizing as well as writing, and just being like at one with yourself and your creative process and the synergy that they bring to the table. I love that intro. All right, let's keep it rolling. There's a fine line between genius and psycho. I'm a psychopath, I'm a killer. Oh, yellow. A psychopath, I'm a killer. A psychopath, I'm a killer. A psychopath, I'm a killer. I love that sort of ghost sound when it sounds like it's haunting the mix. Like it hits and it increases in volume. It's kind of hard to describe. I call it like a ghost effect because it like hits and the noise is almost rewound. Like you rewind it and then it just sounds so weird and then it just hits and you gradually increase the volume before like Yellow's actual voice cuts in it and you can decipher words from it. Just the way that hits, man. Who is this? That is not listed in the title. Somebody's gonna have to tell me below. That is an angel's voice.
I'm never keeping it plain. Lyrical murder is something I've been about. Ever since I was a little kid, doodling in class, drew a picture with my teacher, bullet in his head, ruler in his ass with a toilet in front of him throwing up.
Doodling in class, ruler in his ass. Royce wasting no time, like I talked about, coming in with the complex multi-syllabic schemes. And I love the faster, like choppier flow. Lyrical murder is something I've been about. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Just punching that in, man. And think about this. Picture of my teacher, bullet in his head, a ruler in his ass. He's been twisted ever since he was a child, man. That is colorful imagery right there. I don't know if I ever drew a picture of my teacher doing that.
A little kid doodling in class, drew a picture with my teacher, bullet in his head, ruler in his ass, with a toilet in front of him, throwing up, pissed off. Probably symbolic of this thought, sick talk to my inner enemy in the rough.
Pr- probably symbolic because he's leaning over a toilet. It's so sick and twisted, symbolic of these thoughts that he's having. Hey, this is bad meets evil all over again. In front of I'm throwing up, pissed off. Probably symbolic of this thought, sick talk to my inner enemy in the rough. Probably symbolic of this thought, sick talk. Here it goes. Da 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 da. I love how he just pa-pa-pa-pa like a drummer playing those lines on here, and then he comes up with it. And then Royce just punches up with his cadence, man. Just the way that he bends rhythms is so cool. In front of I'm throwing up, pissed off. Probably symbolic of this thought, sick talk to my inner enemy in the rough. I'm having nightmares of leaving behind my dreams with anything less than the full bang. It's like I'm General Hung and I'm standing in front of a gun. I'm putting myself in the way of a bullet to pull rank. The hood is over my eyes. Full bank, pull rank. Again, I love the schemes and the faster flow. But then we got General Hong. General Hong, that was the that's South Korea, right? That was a general that helped to invent Taekwondo. So what Royce is saying that, you know, he's got the mentality of a general. But at the same time, your soldiers aren't going to fight for you if you're not willing to take a bullet yourself, if you're not there in the front line. So Royce in this street shit is right there in the front lines, leading the battle as he charges forward. General Hung and I'm standing in front of a gun. I'm putting myself in the way of a bullet to pull rank. The hood is over my eyes, but the wool ain't. Yeah, got them in. What is that? Amp distortion right there from a guitar? That's wild coming through on the bass. You're being with a wizard. Every war show, we don't even get considered. Hiding yourself something. What did he just say? Did he just call Eminem a wizard? I think he did. You're a wizard, Harry. Yeah, got the mentality of being with a wizard. Every you war show, we don't even get considered. Hiding yourself something that's so lyrical to a kid who wouldn't know what was hitting if it hit him. Now I want to talk about these niggas from Detroit. Before me and Shady, who was thinking about Detroit? We put the world on tour, so watch how you say fuck me. You just might. We put the world into it, so watch how you say fuck me. Da-da-da-da-da-da. When you are so experienced with the technicals, you can just say sentences however you want. And what I mean is, like, you can slowly punch, you can let things breathe, like you could say a couple words a different way, jump into a totally different rhythm halfway through, and then switch up how you want to end it. That is really being a master technician with the flows and doing this for years and years. And it's so true, man. How long has Royce been doing this? Who put on for Detroit? Who put Detroit on the map? We're talking about Slim Shady and Royce the 5'9", baby. And he's even taking some shots again. Kids these days, you know, are they too lyrical? Why aren't they getting awards for what they do and the time and the effort they put into their craft? We want to celebrate all the stuff that's on the mainstream. We just want to feel a certain way. The beats just got to ride, and that's all we care about. We don't care about what people are saying anymore. Don't worry. We do on this channel. That's why we break shit down and bring that substance, baby. Before me and Shady, who was thinking about Detroit? We put the world on tour, so watch how you say fuck me. You just might jinx yourself. Whoops, your girl gonna do it, because I was in the 9-11. Before you say fuck me, you might jinx yourself because your girl's going to do it. Your girl is going to fuck me. I love how he flips that on the haters right there. If you say fuck me, better watch that, man. Karma's coming around. Tour, so watch how you say fuck me, you just might jinx yourself. Whoops, your girl gonna do it, cause I was in the 9-11 in Chicago, 9-11 at the same time. I had already been grinding since 9-7, that's longevity. Since 9-7, baby. I mean, how long has Nickel been in the game? And he was in that Porsche 9-11 and then playing on 9-11, September 9-11, Chicago, also call 911 when he's riding around. You better be a kid. I'm a psychopath, I'm a killer. You ain't never feel my That makes me think of kind of like Bone Thugs, the way that Yella is doing that faster, dripped out, like harmony rap flow. And the way he holds up, get realer. You ain't never seen a motherfucker get realer. Love that. So smooth. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Cause ain't nobody ill. Nobody for real. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Drinker is the ringleader. I'm a deep thinker. I'm a street preacher with a street sweeper full of heat seekers and your Jeep speakers. I'm a key bringer. I don't need heaters. I got the meat cleaver. Oof. I don't need heaters, meat cleaver, just the whole heat seekers, like that three-syllable scheme. And it's so condensed, man. Like every few words, he's punching that rhyme in. That's what I love. It's not like he's waiting to the end of the line to rhyme that. Like he's just punching it and getting it in just as many times as he can. That's like just relentless jabbing of the flow bag right there. So good with a street sweeper full of heat seekers. If he's coming with that street sweeper, man, he's coming through with that shoddy that's revolving around, but it's got heat seekers, so you can't run away from that. And then actually playing on that, he doesn't need heat. He doesn't need the weapons, because instead of that, instead of the guns, he's got the meat cleaver. And also, like a butcher, literally, they woke. Where's my brain going? Crooked. You're going to make my brain crooked today. Butchers do not work in heated environments, do they? That would spoil the meat. They work in freezers and cold environments. So that's what he's playing on. He's ice cold with it. Love the word play. Street sweeper full of heat sneakers and your Jeep speakers. I'm a key bringer. I don't need heaters. I got the meat. Jeep speakers, keep readers, did it. he did it here with the E sounds and the E rhymes. He comes up with his cadence and then he drops right back down. Heat cleaver, meat cleaver, deep, did it, deep, did it. Kind of like Royce was talking about. When I talk about like playing the drums and then you punch up, that's what he's doing with his voice. Great way to do it, man.
I'm a street preacher with a street sweeper full of heat seekers and your Jeep speakers. I'm a key breakers. I don't need heaters. I got the meat cleaver. Welcome to the slaughterhouse. Niggas try to tell me I spell too much. Capital S to the left to the T-E-R. H-O-U-S-E. Now go to hell, you fucks.
Oh, capital S to the L to the laugh. Right? Because laugh is spelled L-A-U-G-H, which is also a part of him literally spelling out slaughter. Y'all saying that he has too many like word plays where he spells out stuff. Well, guess what? Fuck you, because I'm going to do it again on the track. You hoes, right? Then playing on the U-S-E. Now go to hell, you fucks. Oh, man, that is so smooth and so good.
Tell me I spell too much. Capital S to the left to the T-E-R. H-O-U-S-E. Now go to hell, you fucks. Word. Making work disappear quick as magic. Abracadabra, the traffic of blacker than Africa. Can you imagine a nigga flipping bread for the blood? Money like Dracula has him. Dracula ask me a question. Am I the best with the...
Wow, he is just spazzing on this flow. Traffic a black da 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 da. If I thought that that other condensed scheme was crazy, this one goes in even more. He is snapping on those hard A vowel sounds, man. And bread for the blood, money like Dracula. Dracula going for the blood, and he's talking about blood money, right? From ill-gotten gains is what he's saying.
The work disappeared quick as magic. Abracadabra, the traffic a blacker than Africa. Can you imagine a nigga flipping bread for the blood? Money like Dracula had.
Flipping bread for the blood, like, because literally Dracula would be one of the only people that would change that up. Most people flipping the blood for the bread, right? In that case, because they want the bread. That's the end game. Dracula, on the other hand, is literally flipping it, because what does he want is his end game. He doesn't want bread. He's not going to literally eat bread, but also he doesn't want that money. He wants your blood at the end of the day. So flipping the bread for the blood, that's very, very clever.
Spatula, ask me a question. Am I the best with the flexing? Fuck yes.
And then with a spatula, oh my god, he takes just the... Like, it, that punchline hits already. And then he takes the punchline and just makes it hit even harder by just adding something else to keep flipping the scheme. Literally. This time a spatula, because what does a spatula do? It flips it. So Dracula, if he has a spatula, he's flipping the money for the bread.
Money like Dracula has him. A spatula, ask me a question. Am I the best with the flexing? Fuck yes with the goon talk. I just moonwalk all over the beat. Then I'm lighting up the street. Cookie going like
lighting up the beat like Michael Jackson and Thriller, and Michael Jackson doing the moonwalk and doing the dance when literally the tiles are lighting up in front of him. Ooh, that was a smooth one, man. Hey, wow. Wow, Royce and Crook already just demolished this, and we know we still got him on deck. And I wonder if Yellow Wolf's gonna get a verse.
You ain't never feel my real, get real. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Killin' automatic when anybody's sporadic, got killin'. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Cause ain't nobody killin'.
Oh, this bridge, man. Staring at the full moon. Ow! This is the perfect time of year to do this song.
The thought of retiring is making me want to set your daughter on fire with a soldering ironing. What up, mom? Applying for the rim job. Are you hiring? I'm hoping to fill up your
open. Applying for the rim job. Are you hiring? I love how he comes again. Faster scheme. And all three of these boys have this condensed rhyme scheme. Thought of retiring. Six syllables right there with a soldiering ironing. Six syllable condensed scheme. And he's hitting the ire in between.
Set your daughter on fire with a soldering ironing. What up, mom? Applying for the rim job. Are you hiring? I'm hoping to fill up your opening.
Retiring. Apply for the rim job. Like, gonna slob on his old knob right there and give him a rim job. But also at the same time, the rim job plays off of the tires. Retiring. Like, you're retiring that. I've heard him use that retiring scheme before, but he flipped it in this case with the rim job.
Soldering fire with a soldering ironing. What up, mom? Applying for the rim job. Are you hiring? I'm hoping to fill up your opening. Oh, but I know I gotta meet a lot of requirements. First, I gotta accept you're in a lobby in Ireland. And you probably already been with all the slaughtering. I am in no mood to be playing second fiddle. Slob on this violin with no strings attached.
Oh, my God. You probably already been with all the slaughter, like all the gore and slaughter that I'm bringing, but also literally you've already gotten around probably with all of Slaughterhouse, and I don't really play second fiddle. I like to be number one, right? So I want to just hook up with you with no strings attached, strings on a violin, but also no strings attached relationship. Like, I don't want to get into a relationship with you. I just want to have that hookup. And then the scheme, man, the scheme.
You probably already been with all the slaughter, and I am in no mood to be playing second fiddle. Slob on this violin with no strings attached.
Slaughter and I am in. Right? Slaughter and Iamon. He made that fit in with his six-syllable scheme that he's been carrying since we first talked about at the beginning, right? Slob on this violin. See how he carries that over? Look, one more time. One more time. Let's appreciate what he just did here, man. Soldier and ironin. Thought of retiring. And then he keeps carrying it on. Lot of requirements. Wow.
Are you hiring? I'm hoping to fill up your opening. Oh, but I know I gotta meet a lot of requirements. First, I gotta accept you're in a lobby at Ireland. And you probably already been with all the slaughter and I am in no mood to be playing second fiddle slob on this violin. With no strings attached, I'm just a product of a hostile environment. But being brought up so...
No, he didn't. Hostile environment? How can you do that? This is like Renegade right here, just locked into the complex rhyme.
No need to be playing second fiddle slob on this violin. With no strings attached, I'm just a product of a hostile environment. But being brought up, so brought up inspired. But I don't know why I still like I'm caught up inside a whirlpool. Not an appliance, but applying to science. I psychotically rhyme and it's like stars.
Caught up in a whirlpool, not an appliance, but I'm applying to science. Like being caught in a whirlpool, right? Like a wash machine. But in this case, he's not talking about that. He's talking about like a literal whirlpool, like out at sea, and the chaos that is going on in his mind right now.
Why is it like I'm caught up inside a whirlpool? Not an appliance, but applying the science. I psychotically rhyme, and it's like stars.
Like a whirlpool. Pause. Not in the science. Like, great moment to pause because he's coming so fast with the schemes. He just wants you to like catch up with him, let it sink in, and then he just jumps right back into the complexity.
Why is it like I'm caught up inside a whirlpool? Not an appliance, but applying the science. I psychotically rhyme, and it's like stars of a lion, all in a lion's heart of a lion, balls of a lion. Obscene talk.
All in a lion's heart of a lion, balls of Goliath. Hear how he just like casually, but so quickly. That's hard to do, to deliver it so fast, but to change your cadence that quickly as well, and to keep bending the rhymes and the words. Heart of a lion. Right, like David, heart of a lion, but then he's got the balls of Goliath because he's massive, he's a giant in this game, so he's got the best of both worlds.
Applying to science, I psychotically rhyme, and it's like stars of a lion, all in a lion, heart of a lion, balls of Goliath. Obscene talking, it's wine like a beanstalk in a vine, but I keep walking the line between the wrong and the
beanstalk and keep walking. We heard Crooked do this, eat dooda, eat dooda, eat dooda. He's doing it now. Like a bed creaking with the rhyme scheme. Eat on, eat on.
Thought of a lion, balls of a lion. Obscene talking, it's wine like a beanstalk in a vine. But I keep walking the line between the wrong and the right. But everything I write seems wrong. And it's like I'm ecstatic at all the static.
Like Jack going up the beanstalk right now, telling fairy tales. Obscene talking, trying to deal with
him. Stalk in a vine, but I keep walking the line between the wrong and the right. But everything I write seems wrong. And it's like I'm ecstatic at all the static that I can still cause in the fabric of our modern society. Now Catholics are panicking because I snap back to my...
All the static that I can still cause in the fabric of modern society, and then like between wrong and the right, but everything that I write is wrong. Get how he plays on right, R-I-G-H-T, but then W-R-I-T-E, nice little flip on that, and then playing off of the two opposite sides because they come together and two opposites just creating this static, but also literally like static with society, like trouble, controversy that he stirs up with the fabrics of society itself, like literal fabrics, but also like the greater sort of metaphysical understanding of fabric of society. Come on, M. That's ridiculous.
I'm ecstatic at all the static that I can still cause in the fabric of our modern society. Now Catholics are panicking because I snap back to my old annex and shenanigans. Damn it, the Pope's man.
Take a bath with the Catholics in holy water. No wonder they try to hold me under longer. I'm a motherfucking spiteful, delightful, Eiffel, the new Ice Cube. Motherfuckers hate to like you. What did I do? I'm just a kid from the gutter making his butter off these blood suckers. What track is that from? Comment down below.
But I keep walking the line between the wrong and the right, but everything I write seems wrong, and it's like I'm ecstatic at all the static that I can still cause in the fabric of our modern society. Now Catholics are panicking because I snap back to my old annex and shenanigans. Damn it, the Pope's mad again. Probably shouldn't have ran up in the Vatican with that mannequin singing bagpipes from Baghdad again. And my dad's dragging a faggot in a glad bag. Won't be the last time I'm...
Oh, a glad bag. Literally a glad bag being dragged in that, but also glad. That is a gay, lesbian... Oh, I can't remember the acronym, but it's GLAAD, something for awareness of against discrimination along those lines. So he's playing off of that, but also he drops the F word that he's been picketed for, that people have said that he is using gay slurs for, but he's like, hey, I'm back to it. And Bagpipes from Baghdad, song that I've never done on this channel. Have I even heard Bagpipes from Baghdad? But just the irony of that he's walking into the Vatican with that. And then obviously the Catholic line, shout out the song that I told you to comment below. I love how he's bringing old discographies back. Like the old Shady is back in this situation. And in this case, doing crazy shit again.
Mannequin singing bagpipes from
And also drag could be taken as, you know, a man dressing up in drag as a woman. And again, playing off of the him not being very friendly to the bis and the gays. And yeah, there you go. Eminem.
He is who he is. He's not changing at this point.
Vatican in my dad's drag, dragging a faggot in. A glad bag won't be the last time I make a dramatic entrance like that again. You thought I was lying.
Dramatic entrance like that again? He just made dramatic entrance fit in with the glad bag and dragon scheme. So clever. And like I said, when you just have a mastery of the flow, you can just do that. Just like slow down and just like punch it and just like squeeze it into your scheme. And that's exactly what he did.
Back dragging a faggot in a glad bag won't be the last time I make a dramatic entrance like Vatican. You thought I was lying when I said I think that I'm crossing the line again. I've lost my mind, Carson. Oh God, I think I just thought of another fucking line. Forgive me, Father, for Iceland.
Wow, I love him going like harder, the aggressive flow. Ah. Come
on. I'm crossing the line again. I've lost my mind, Carson. Oh God, I think I just thought of another fucking line. Forgive me, Father, for Iceland. But hip hop.
Just thought of another line. Like, literally, when you're crossing the line, but he's thought of another line that he can now cross, but also a line within this rap.
Crossing the line again. I've lost my mind. Carson, oh God, I think I just thought of another fucking line. Forgive me, Father, for Iceland. But hip-hop is stepping.
Crossing a line. Caution. Oh God. Again, the complexities of the rhyme schemes you have to appreciate in between all this crazy wordplay and just cadence change and flow changes.
I've lost my mind. Caution. Oh God, I think I just thought of another fucking line. Forgive me, Father, for Iceland. But hip-hop is stepping. Brainwashed with a violent street. Defiant. Now the odds of me trying to fucking be quiet probably gotta be about as high as the Jolly Green Giant after he's fallen and pollen next to a killer beehive colony trying to sneak by it.
And what was that? Just little strings. Da 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 da. I love how when M raps, there's always just these like random production sounds that just get included just to highlight different things that he's saying, man. It's crazy. And then the Jolly Green Giant falling next to pollen. I can't imagine someone as big and massive as the Jolly Green Giant falling into a killer beehive colony. Wow. The imagination of
I probably gotta be about as high as the Jolly Green Giant after he's fallen and pollen next to a killer beehive colony trying to sneak by it. All his feet don't follow me while I revive rap.
He's never gonna sneak by a beehive colony with how massive he is, what I'm saying. You got no chance, but
he's falling and pollen next to a killer beehive colony trying to sneak by it. All his feet don't follow me while I revive rap. I'ma start up a rioting, trying to stop at a silence that you're not gonna. Might as well just hit the block and you're jogging a tiring. Boston, across the marathon, finish line and put your.
Oh my God, put your jogging attire. Crossing the line like the Boston Marathon, like the bombing at the Boston Marathon. And again, that synth, just random production elements being introduced. I love it, man.
So you're not gonna, might as well just hit the block and you're jogging a tire in Boston across the marathon finish line and put your thoughts against mine, cause the arsenal I have a scar you for life, worse than your arsenal I have a bronze players and
arsenal I have a scar you for life. Again, just latching on to the different vowel sounds and punching the internal rhyme schemes as well as the external complex schemes, man. This is what he's known for. He just gets in the bag when he gets
finished
this.
Lining put your thoughts against mine, cause the arsenal I have a scar you for life, worse than your arsenal I have a bronze players and barbed wire. Your boss like Barney fight.
Worse than, I think, isn't it Eisenjahars? I think that's the name of the guy who, you know, obviously committed the horrible atrocities of the Boston Marathon bombing. So he's fit him. Bending the words into the scheme. Wow.
It's mine, cause the arsenal I have a scar you for life, worse than your arsenal I have a bronze players and barbed wire. Your boss like Barney Fife with a fucking Swiss Army knife. A savior the stars faded with arthritis in a park.
Barney Fife? Barney Fife? The Andy Griffith Show? Yep, he just did that. He's basically saying you're a harmless little bitch.
Bronze players and barbed wire. Your boss like Barney Fife with a fucking Swiss Army knife. A savior the stars faded with arthritis in a bar fight with the Dark Knight on a dark night.
Saberless Darth Vader with arthritis at a bar fight, because Darth Vader, actually, I don't know if I like that one, M, because he could still just, you know, use the force and choke you out. But what he's saying, Darth Vader always has his saber. Like, you don't have your weapons on you. You can't deal with me, baby, especially if he's got arthritis and he's all shaking. He can't control himself.
His arms tied up. I'm dumb like when I'm a saber the stars faded with arthritis in a bar fight with the Dark Knight on a dark night with his arms tied up. I'm dumb like when
Darth fight on a dark night. Da 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 da. I love how he punches that before the percussion hits. Again, it just makes things sound so different in terms of the rhythm and the pockets that he finds to flow with. In the Dark Knight, on a dark night, get how he's playing off of that. Nice.
And I save the stars faded with arthritis in a bar fight with the Dark Knight on a dark night with his arms tied up. I'm dumb like when I'm on the mic. I'm not gonna lie. Perform like I'm gonna die at the end of a song, so it's hard for the rhyme to end. Like fuck them all. I'm just riding like I'm not.
Dahmer, man, he loves. Shout out Jeffrey Dahmer, man. Cannibal, serial killing ass mofo. That's what M is whenever he gets on the mic. And then he's rhyming like he's gonna die. And he's killed himself on tracks before. But what he's saying is like he's rhyming like this is his last. That's why he always takes so long. Why he doesn't have like normal 16 bar verses. We're like into 32 bars now.
I'm not gonna lie, perform like I'm gonna die at the end of a song, so it's hard for the rhyme to end. Like fuck them all, I'm just riding like I'm locked up.
Also, but if he dies at the end of the song, he can't continue the rhyme, so that's kind of a double.
I got a shot of Bonnie and Clyde call, but Ronnie just driving, about to bust the side door, rock of asylum and park in the dining room.
Oh my God, Bonnie and Clyde shouting out his song, Bonnie and Clyde, but also Bonnie and Clyde got shot up in a car. That's how them, the criminal couple, died. And then shouting out Uncle Ronnie. Didn't Uncle Ronnie kill himself? I think so. M's Uncle Ronnie. He's had Ronnie in songs before. And then they're all crashing into Arkham Insane Asylum, which ties in with the Dark Knight, because the Arkham Asylum, where the Joker was locked up and all these different criminals, just bringing it back to that and the psychopath man in mind that Eminem is. And you hear the car crash ad-lib in the background as he just crashes at the end of a track. So he kind of hinted that he was going to rhyme like he's going to die, and then car crash hits. Almost like it's over. He's died again on yet another track.
Bonnie and Clyde call, but Ronnie just driving, about to bust the side door, rock of asylum and park in the dining room.
Wow. Insane, man. Wow. What a ride, man. What an absolute ride. Can we get Slaughterhouse back, please? Can we? That is a perfect song for this time of year. That is the perfect song if you like lyrical rap, crazy internal rhyme schemes and flows. My only wish is that Yellow Wolf had a verse too, because we know Yellow Wolf can kill it, man. But that was so smooth. And M goes last for a reason. But Eminem, Royce da 5'9", King Crooked, Yellow Wolf. You were Knoxville certified. Flip it, guys, like today's video. If you did, be sure to smash that like button. Comment down below any other Eminem, Royce songs you want to see me do, King Crooked songs, Yellow Wolf, or there's other artists you want to see me check out. I try to read all of your comments, guys. I respond as best I can, so please keep commenting and keep posting. Also, if for some reason you're here at the end of this video, obviously you're enjoying the content, do me a favor, support the channel directly, subscribe and notifications on. As always, it's your reminder to stay safe, stay positive. It's Knoxville. I'll catch you again. I'm out.